Right, hey guys, how are we doing? Back another video from Team 4 Star on the 4 Star Bento channel, continuing with the Dragon Ball Z Abridged Creator Commentary Series, and we have got Super Android 13. This is great. I love this film. I love the running jokes that come into this from the main series. I think my favourite parts is with Trunks and Vegeta. It's more androids. And Trunks like, oh, please don't let my dad know. And is this the one where it's got the Vegeta being like, for years I lay dormant, blah, 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 in the ice thing? Is that what this one is? Been a while, so yeah, let's just get into it.
Well, howdy there, folks, and welcome back.
That's right, folks. I hope you're ready for a trucking good time.
I'd like to point out, as the only one out of the three of us who actually grew up with an accent anywhere close to this, both of y'all are real offensive.
Well, damn. You. My grandpappy was in Missouri for my entire life, and I would visit, like, you know, at least once yearly, so I got my exposure.
Now, here's the problem I have with what you said there, Kaiser Neko. I've always pitched different accents to you. You've always said, no, I want an exotic accent. So I'm going to tell you right now, bud, and I'm a straight shooter here. I'm going to say this right now. You're spare change, bud. That's what you've always been, as far as when it comes to accents.
I don't know.
Is that Newfoundland?
That's just rural Canadian.
Rural Canadian.
Yeah, bud.
That's why when Letterkenny came out, everyone was like, that's like my time. No, that's just rural Canada, guys. That's not one province. That's all of rural Canada, okay?
Okay.
To be fair.
Android 13, another one of those movies where you were not involved in the primary writing. This was Kaiser, no. Kieran, and this myself.
Was, I think this, because this one was written at the same time as the last episode.
What? The one that would have been written in tandem with this would have been World's Strongest, because we were working towards our 2 million subscribers.
Were you working on two movies at the same time?
Yes.
Whoa. Oh my god, yeah. Oh, I cannot wait. I cannot wait to get to World's Strongest.
World's Strongest is one of my favorite movies that we've done, by far.
This is one of my favorite DBZ movies, actually. Not all of them I like, but I just like
Super
this one because
13.
It starts
okay.
In a fucking city. And that is neat to me.
Also, big landmark here in terms of the production of the show. First time we used completely new drawn flaps from another artist. So,
ooh,
yeah, first episode. Cool. Our first production where we have new flaps.
As we were going through this with Kieran, like, this was one of those scripts that really flowed. We had, I want to say, 60% of the rough draft done in one night. The lines were just flowing out of it, especially a lot of Android 13 Southernisms. We would end up casting Mick Lauer to play, who would do this fantastic job.
So he is also TJ from TJ and the Wombat.
He's also John Kirstein of Tron.
That's right.
in the forgotten Attack on Titan.
The greatest one-shot ever.
We weren't allowed to keep on the internet.
The greatest one-shot ever!
Yeah, it's a shame about that. Like, I heard about that. I remember reacting. Did I? I think I did a reaction to it years ago, and other people did reactions, and it was like, they were like, we weren't allowed to keep ours out there. And it's like,
one day maybe we'll be able to talk about that properly.
Mean an empty, sterile room.
But for now,
give my short little time.
But for now, look at my trucker hat!
Super Android 13!
It's a fan-based parody. Dragon Ball, Dragon Ball Z, and Dragon Ball GT are
Why didn't Dr. Gero just send all the androids at once?
Because shut up.
Akira Toriyama. Because
that before.
I guess I'll just be quiet.
Oh no.
Thank you.
This was so
good. Oh yeah.
This was great.
We knew this had to be the framing device.
This is a reanimated version of it, correct?
Yeah. Yeah.
Well,
partially.
Partially when you make the shift.
Once he smashes the head, it is.
And you will do what I say.
I'm sorry. Could you repeat that? I think the ear thing's back.
I said I am your master, and you will do what I
don't think so.
Sorry, Doc. Just following orders.
So, could one of you possibly spare one of those?
Put the shader filter on.
There's the movie.
Extra shadow on the face.
Whoa.
Yep.
He's oil blood.
I love this sound. You hear everything going on up there.
I love when you hear like something that was happening in an original shot happening in a new shot.
Also, we got Guerrero back.
Yes.
Cool.
Now, what to do with
the... Oh yeah, cool. So the guy that did Cooler's voice, yeah.
Wind's going rogue.
How is progress with Plan B?
My one line.
Wow. Bravo! Bravo, me.
Well, I guess it's time for Plan C.
Thank you for letting that joke so I can technically be in the credits.
Yep. And here we go.
I love this. This is so great.
Props to you for this, man.
So cool. Let's go.
We're going to continue the Korin and Yajirobe subplot.
Continues. It continues.
I love it.
It's
great.
I love this part of the show. This is... Here it comes.
Touch those tie silk curtains and I'll turn one of those hoop earrings into a...
Stop the drink!
Wow. Mom sure is set on filling out Korin and Yajirobe's wedding registry.
We were sitting there, I was like, why are they shopping?
Yeah, what's
They're
the reason?
Get wedding gifts.
They make it fit in with the, yeah.
It's for Korin and Yajirobe.
I remember sitting down looking at the script, I'm like, that's perfect. That's perfect.
Yeah, I was so happy with that. Like, just building
it's
this
great.
Subplot in the background with these two...
I love that, yeah, the movies are like, basically like, the side story is that relationship.
Three side characters who we made into a, like, a couple.
And it would finally come to a head in the next movie.
Yep.
Yes.
And yeah, that would be the final time that would really be brought up in canon.
It is kind of astonishing how many things we wrapped up, like, heading into that portion.
Yeah.
Because what would we do if they went on to BoJack? Are they getting a divorce now? Oh, no.
Whoa.
It's a trial separation. A trial separation.
I don't even think they're in the movie at all.
I know.
No, they're not.
Then again, they aren't in this one either.
Yeah, they weren't in this one or Broly, so.
But why do they need six crock pots? And why all these
delicious-looking
bath
bombs?
I don't even think they have a bathroom. Korin always just told me to go over the side.
Okay. I'm Oopa. So, there is a version of the script where originally it's just Oopa and Bora.
Just chilling. Scott, to those who've never seen Dragon Ball, who the fuck are those people?
Oh, yeah. Oopa and Bora. Oopa is the little Indian boy.
Right.
Sorry, Native American boy. Well,
there is no America.
There is no America. The little indigenous...
Inuit boy?
No.
Indigenous.
Look, I'm just saying Native
that
American.
Person
we're moving
that
on.
Person.
The little Native American boy who, you know, his father gets killed, then gets brought back. It's a whole thing with Mercenary Tao. And then
they live at the base of Korin Tower.
They live at the base of Korin Tower. Now, we were going to have a joke that they were going to be hanging out at the bottom of the tower, and Oopa was going to look and say, "Father, what is that?" And then you just see shadow over his face before it cuts away.
That would be. Well, I mean.
Oh, here we go. Here we go.
The most ridiculous looking character design.
I can't. This is.
Oh yeah.
Also, hold on. I just want to get to 15's first line.
Like they never seen a purple dwarf before.
Okay.
So,
I can't wait to see what the idea was behind the way he speaks like that.
Hoping we can do here is, Nyes, I'm hoping that we can layer over the images that we're using after I explain this, but this was Kieran's pitch. Because he loves the, like, extra, like, you know, crypto puzzle kind of thing.
Yeah.
Mm. And the reason he talks like that is because that is an image turned into a sound file.
No way.
Which can be reconverted using a program that we do have linked in the description of the original Super
Android 13
video.
Oh my god, that's sick.
Like they never seen a purple dwarf before. I know, right? Racist as shit.
I remember that me even linking that in the description, people were I think like you even didn't want me to do that because it was giving too much away.
I didn't fight against it because I thought like people need a hint.
Also, shout out to once again the MVP of playing minions in our show, Antfish, playing yet another minion and knocking that out of the park.
I remember when we were going over this and Anthony's like, "So you're letting me audition for Android 15, right?" I'm like, "Yeah, I mean, yeah." And then he just came in and he nailed it because he, of course, he did.
Cool.
Listen,
he's a little purple pimp.
He is a little bit of a
purple.
He's purple.
He's purple.
I mean, unless you're colorblind.
Yeah, I, 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 There's something to be said about these 1980/1990s Japanese animation designs.
Are we going to talk about Android 14 looking like a albino, a Native American warrior of some kind?
All I'm saying is there's a lot to unpack here, but not by us.
That's exactly it. That's for the scholars and the fools.
Exactly.
The timing.
Oh, by the way. For those with eagle ears, I don't think eagle ears is a thing.
Eagle ears?
With those for,
eagle
eyes. With kitty cat ears.
Namekian ears.
There we go. Mm. Found it, workshopped it, got it.
Good.
Richard Cheese is playing in the background.
Yeah.
The sickness.
Yes.
Get up, get up, get down with the sickness. Your mother, get up.
Because
on,
I was
get
on a...
down. With the sickness, so many good covers that he's like, he's done like that. He's even done a because Down in Sickness that played at the end of what was the horror movie, and that's what got me into it. And then he's done a people equal shit, people equal shit, and all that. It's like
fake yeah. Richard Cheese kick, and I just wanted to fit him into the background.
Open up your head and let it flow.
Shopping makes you hungry. Only shopping. Uh-huh. Speaking of, how'd your search go, guys?
I love this joke. It's so great.
Roshi is banned from over 500 Victoria's Secret locations. I don't get it. How are you not on some kind of list?
You think Master Roshi is my real name?
I forgot about that. That was great.
By the way,
Jackie Chun is banned from a lot of places.
I'd like to point out that shot there with a bunch of different characters talking and eating and looping animation and oh my god.
Yeah.
Well, don't you like the higher animation quality of the movie, Scott? Doesn't it make for fun editing?
Helsing was...
Well, that was stabilized footage.
Yeah, at least...
Oof, take that. Yeah, Helsing's much higher standard, isn't it?
You know what? The difference between this footage and the Helsing footage. Helsing had better animation, but at least when it was holding on a shot, it wasn't fucking shaking in place.
Right, at least fair. It held on a shot.
It's that's what you said. Why do you like working on Helsing more? It's stabilized! It's stabilized!
You just had to worry about hair.
The only thing unstable here is me!
Why are there so many moving hair shots?
You specialize in women's underwear?
I love this.
Why would Korin and Yajirobe...
Stop thinking about it.
Oh.
Which one?
Where's them? Good
so
question.
Nah.
Blue can.
Love it.
That is such a cool shot.
Hey, wow.
So that's neat. This is very different. This is...
But the restaurant is shaking.
Huh? Yeah. Yeah.
Baskets.
These shots are great.
Go anywhere as a group without something blowing up. Probably not my fault this time,
maybe. That shot.
Yeah.
Of Goku just carrying a dozen people.
Yeah,
sorry,
cool.
Everybody. Sorry. Sorry.
By the way, trying to find sound effects for putting down a bunch of bodies like that.
I can't.
Also more difficult than you might think.
How many bodies?
Yeah, it's like they can't all just sound exactly the same.
What did you have to put down?
Did you type in "let the bodies hit the floor" sound effect?
Nice. Cut that.
Terrorists! Wait, I can't sense them.
Goku's...
Android!
Moscow's
Androiderists! Terroroids!
Guys, we gotta...
Bad case of terroroids!
Once again, I'm pretty sure that was a Kieran pitch.
That might have been, yeah.
Kieran is so immensely funny. Guys, if you haven't checked out the Good Time Zone,
I need to watch
now.
It.
She has to feed two Saiyans.
Yeah, I know, right?
So, you guys aren't orgasmic.
Orgasmic.
Red ribbon? I mean, you've got it on your red ribbon.
Potential weak point.
Yep. You know what they say about
assuming. It makes an ass out of you
and me.
Scan complete. This guy's dumb as bricks.
Say what?
Oh, right. Your unrefined meatbag ears probably don't understand him. He's introducing himself as Android 14. I am Android 15. And you... Goku.
Love this.
Oof. I love the music I got to use.
Good thing it's Sunday and all those buildings are empty.
Is that actually the line?
No.
No.
That's, I think that was in Dawn of Justice.
No, that's in the Ocean dub when Vegeta and Nappa blow up the town.
Nope. No, maybe we shouldn't do this here.
I know a place.
Whee!
Logically, this makes a lot of sense.
Yeah, it does. Like, there's lots of people around, and it makes sense to run away.
Krillin, we should go after them.
Should we?
Yeah.
Okay, but must we?
Well, you can come with me, or you can stay here with my mom.
We must!
Oh, shoot. Can you go back just a frame? Okay, so.
Oh, he's got an itchy ass.
Yeah, well,
my butt!
Originally, this is after Chi-Chi kicks him.
Yeah.
So they just... Yeah, okay, cut that out. So, yeah.
But... Alright. What do you think the edit here is?
Those are two separate beams.
Those were two separate ones in that shot, but I needed them flying
at the same time.
At the same time.
Whoa.
You're so good.
Updates complete.
Oh, here we go.
Now activating number 13.
Oh god, the hell of it onto the top like Darth Vader from Star Wars. Brilliant.
My favorite funny edit.
Mighty kind of you, Doctor.
Rice is so good.
Dog, you can't fix what ain't broke. Now, where's my truck?
Looks so much like Sal in this.
Dunk, 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 dunk.
So good.
The amount of people who think that's not added in. The amount of people who think that's not added in. Like, oh, that's clearly in the anime. I'm like, no, that's added in, guys. That's... Really? You couldn't tell?
How could you? What? There's no way.
That one was added in?
No way people thought that was...
Reflection, I wish I'd had a... Like
the hat straight on?
Well, no. Actually, the hat not straight on is perfect because then you can
then
tell
you can
it's
tell
a trucker
it's a hat. Gotcha.
Yeah, no. So later on, and like I would find a set of 2D/cartoony effects.
Oh, steam.
Yeah,
like
steam,
like
smoke, stuff like that. Wish I'd had that for this because... It would have looked a little bit better than the more realistic.
I think this still looks great. This sells the joke. The fact that people don't know it's an edit is point.
And it's just jank enough to be.
I suppose that goes to show how good the edit actually is. If people thought it was like genuinely from the anime, that's just mad though that people actually think that was. God.
Charming. So it's
watch
like,
the movie.
Jank enough to be charming is I can settle for that.
Yeah. And I don't know.
This is a comedy. It's okay to be.
I remember Kieran and I were like, it needs to come down to a Darth Vader, like a banjo Darth Vader thing.
Yeah, oh yeah, 100%.
The Hyperial March.
No offense, Goku, but why the Arctic?
What?
You're fine. You've got a jacket.
Well, yeah, but there are more deserts than we can count, and you chose the Arctic.
You got a jacket.
My database says...
Use a bitch. I highly doubt that's what it said.
I doubt that.
I wish his hands were on his hips. I highly doubt that's what it said.
Jacket is weighing you down.
Oh, some of the animation in this movie is just so...
Yeah.
Hey, Goku, if and when we make it out of this, please don't tell my father that...
Yeah, here we go.
There were two more androids.
Well, to be fair,
you'd be wrong anyway.
To be fair.
Three.
Okay.
This movie does get a lot of points for just having different scenery than the rest of them.
Oh, yeah. There's not a, like, I can't even remember another Dragon Ball.
World's Strongest is the only other one that takes place in the Arctic.
So I would imagine it's just over slightly to the left over there.
Also, I used a lot of Borderlands music in this.
Mm-hmm.
Because Borderlands, first of all, has a really good soundtrack.
Okay.
Like, kudos to...
Second of all, we ended up being in it.
That's true.
Yeah.
Oh.
Yeah.
Well, you guys.
We ended up being
in
it.
Yeah, congrats. Congrats, guys. What? I'm congratulating you.
You live in Canada.
Yeah. What am I supposed to do?
Not live in Canada?
Yeah.
I'm going to be honest.
Enjoy your health care.
Hey, it's free.
Enjoy your health care and legal weed.
I do enjoy those.
A lot. I really wanted to use them because it just kind of felt perfect for, an android who's also a redneck.
Yeah?
Yep.
So
it really didn't work out, because that's the aesthetic of that game.
Sci-fi.
Mick putting on a clinic of performing.
Yeah, sci-fi western.
I'm Android 13. Look at my truck.
Look at it!
It's right there. Ribs. Red ribs.
You're kidding me. Are there any more of you that we don't know about?
Nah, just us. Plus the green one in the sub-lab.
Enough! I have had it with these monkey fighting androids!
And this Monday to Friday timeline!
A
Again, with our love of the TV sensors.
Yeah, using TV sensors in place of the actual lions is funny. One of our most pastime
about. This was snakes on a plane. I'm tired of
this. This was snakes on a plane. I keep snakes on this Monday to Friday plane. I will say the actual dub of this movie has possibly one of the best reworked lines. Don't you lecture me with your $30 haircut. Goku dies.
We tried to find ways to work that in, but it just...
It was actually my mom cuts my hair.
I will say, $30. He's got a bowl cut. Mm.
What? You put a bowl on there, and you start.
Cutting. Oh well, pardon me, Mister. I can afford a bowl.
Unlike you, we have napkins. That's what we use. Napkins.
We eat out of the tin.
Well, look. Oh, look at you, Mister. I've got $30 to spare on cutting my hair.
Oh my God.
Well, son, looks like 13 is your unlucky number.
I don't believe in superstitions.
How in the blazes did Jiro have so much trouble killing you?
I'm very stubborn.
Oh, hey, he's actually really strong.
He's got red attack. Oh, no!
Red strong.
Yeah, son, you might catch a death of cold.
Here comes one of my good favorite visual lines from him.
Catch this guy.
A trucker hat! You plung dung dang dang on did it now, son! Who in the
what? Just the biggest southernism.
You took my hat!
Hope Trunks is having better luck.
Why did I even bring this? Wait, why did I bring this? We were shopping before.
Yeah,
one observation.
That's
I had.
Yeah, so just point out, like, love break the fourth wall, just like talking about, like, yeah, why did I bring this? We were shopping before.
This.
Yeah.
I love your yelp.
Go back. I want to hear it again.
Do you know how hard it is to track to an exact moment on this?
Yeah.
Yeah. Just do it.
I did a good job.
You did great. I actually
can't dodge my TH death ball.
Does the TH stand for...
Truckerhead, yes!
Not my first guess.
I don't know what his first guess was.
Tryhard? Yes. I don't know.
Yes.
Yeah. Here we go.
Here we go. This might...
This is it, isn't it? This is the Vegeta moment.
Might be my favorite joke.
What now? Huh? For thousands of years, I lay dormant.
Who has disturbed my...
Best buddy?
Oh, it's you. Explain, idiot.
I love it.
No. Three more androids.
Damn it!
Three whole androids, huh?
Pretty sure that makes eight.
Eight.
Never letting the boy in the one down.
Well, if it ain't the prince.
Good day,
your majesty. I tip my hat to you. But I lost it!
Okay, he's also a character in Hellsing as well, and he plays Judd Forrest.
Okay.
Oh, he plays Judd Forrest.
And you are?
Judd Forrest from the South Carolina Baptist Confederate Congregation. I got me here some 300 and change good old boys.
Well, I hope they do a... I know I've said it before, but I hope they do... Once they finish these Dragon Ball Z Abridged things, they do the Hellsing Ultimate. Because why not?
It's from the Knights of the Hanging Noose.
Wow, all right, okay. Thank you for swinging by. Oh.
See here. The kind Dr. Jerome deemed us, in his own words,
defective.
Leaving us on the proverbial shelf until, well, he got
one of the options.
So, what's your detective?
He could not quite tolerate my dulcet tones, my choice in vernacular, and my particular method of articulation.
The head wobble.
Yep.
What about him?
Such a great joke. I love it.
All right, but what about the small one?
I speak binary.
Is it because he's purple?
Okay,
racist.
If you must know, it's because he's got a drinking problem.
Hey, it's only a problem when I run out.
We don't like to talk about it.
Now, I believe we have some business to attend to.
Eat est.
Laying three corpses upon this here glacier.
Oh, such a good line.
By the way, I loved writing for him. I wrote a lot. I actually wrote like a decent amount of his lines, like maybe not most, but I like the articulation line was
articulation.
Me. I remember specifically that I wrote that out, mostly because I just love writing a redneck with a stupendous vocabulary.
Much like Guerrero is cooler, not to knock the dub actors. Miklar could be this dub actor.
Here's the thing. Mick is just a fantastic actor in general.
Yes, he is. Like, which is why he got cast in JoJo.
I don't have a problem when saying, like, yeah, you know what? I think one of our interpretations could work in a dub. I don't mind saying that.
We don't go, like...
These are the movies.
When it comes to casting, like, large characters in a movie, we do our vetting. We know who we're working with beforehand in terms of, like, how good they are as an actor.
There are several actors in our movies. Like, when we get a guest star... A lot of them, like, are... Sung Won Cho was in a couple of our
shorts and stuff.
And he was in Helsing as well.
He made an amazing Whis for us.
And Mick Lauer's gone on to do things. Marnoka is in a ton of stuff.
Mm. And he'll be in the next movie.
Oh my god. Joshua Tomar.
Mm. Yeah. Oh, he was in episode 4, for God's sake.
Yeah, like, I am very proud of the amazing people we've been able to work with. I'm honored, I'm humbled. Little Lauer's just killing it here.
I'm gonna tell you right now, the guy who's playing Android,
this is 15.
Ant has gone on to do professional, commercial, national.
I mean, most of the people we work with do like
that's
pro
so
shit.
Cool. Yeah. That they
oh
have
man,
gone.
Anthony's doing a lot nowadays.
Mm-hmm.
15.
You got it, boss man.
That's a good animation joke.
You forget you saw this.
That one was new. That's a new clap.
Round two!
Fleshlights! Favorite. Oh my god, so good. I love this joke.
Oh yeah.
Loop, loop, loop.
So brutal. Damn. I made sure to have the sound of like a piss, like a thing like.
I think this is, I will say this. Android 14, 15 is more like a cyborg. 14 is clearly a pure robotic android.
Yeah. Oh yeah, yeah. I think the only one out of them with any actual, like, biology might be 13.
Might be,
Well, 14 and 15 are pure
all three are proper androids.
Yeah. So I'm wondering why 15 is drinking then. Is that how, all right, the energy,
it's like,
would
like,
be
it's
alcohol.
Like, it's like Bender.
Oh yeah. My god, he's Bender.
Yeah, he's bending.
Bite my shite purple ass.
We just needed to be
this.
Here, didn't we?
By the way, my favorite part about these.
Jacket. Just had to beeline it for the Arctic.
Okay, Krillin, I get it. We're not helping. I just needed some space from my mom.
Oh.
It's all right.
Wanna have a snowball fight?
Probably not a good time.
No, you're right.
So, you see how they, like, kind of pop up and then pop up and then, like, you know, like, originally in the animation, they just straight come up. But I thought, you know what? No, I'm gonna have a hitch there.
We just needed to be here, huh?
So I suppose what you could do with the editing with that is they're like, split it straight down the middle because the camera doesn't work, doesn't move, and then pause that side, and then keep it laid over until you need to, and then, yeah, that'd be cool.
When we were watching through, it's like, why the fuck are they there?
It's true.
They have
as much purpose as Bulma did on Namek.
They're emotional support. They're moral support. That's why they are there
to sell the stakes later on in the fight.
I think in the movie Krillin actually does take a hit somewhere for.
Oh, he does indeed.
But we just decided to skip that entirely and have more fun with it.
Yep.
Yes. Surfing on Vegeta.
A fucking snowboard Vegeta.
Hey. Want to see something cool?
Yeah, okay.
Yeah, okay.
That's so silly.
All right.
Super Saiyan.
All right, Super Saiyan.
All right,
Super Saiyan.
Can't believe they keep forgetting.
And the final joke that people don't get.
Shit.
That's Super Saiyan.
Why did it take them so long to do that?
You know, I stopped asking that question a long time ago.
So, are you ready to die, android?
This was a great edit. Was this my idea?
That's an Archer joke.
Yeah.
This was my idea?
No, I can't remember who.
Does that even
it was one
do
of us.
For you?
Not anymore.
So dark. By the way, he says mother right there.
That's right, Goku. Send them back to Arkansas.
It's pronounced Arkansas, you idiot.
Idiot.
By the way.
Consider my pet peeve.
One.
Yeah. We. I, it, the correct one would have been for him to have said Arkansas and for Android 13 to have said Arkansas.
But it's funnier,
but it's
the,
funnier
other
the other way.
You know, that's actually a crime to intentionally do that in that state. To say
is it
wrong? Apparently.
Oh.
I want that to be true.
I want it to be true as well. So chat, tell us if it's true or not.
Also, Goku looking pretty cool right there.
Oh yeah. Looking very cool.
I love
Piccolo
this.
Piccolo help.
Piccolo help!
And then...
Thousands
of years I lay dormant.
Who has disturbed my...
Oh, hey, Goku, what's up?
Hey, mind if I take a spin?
I love his goofy scream.
I love it. Ah! I love the sound keeps going, like it's not like an isolated little bubble. It's still happening off to the side.
Yeah. By the way, the Yahoo! Not in the script.
Yeah,
that was just
him.
Mick doing it.
That was just Mick just looked at the footage and went, oh yeah, I am.
Yeah, I could do that.
I also like Kieran and I were dying over the thousands of years I lay dormant thing. Because it's like, why are they just under the ice?
Why
like
are they under the ice? Did they like, oh, they're there. I'm going to go underneath them.
Exactly. Like Piccolo would miss that. Thanks, I've been under there practicing it for, never mind.
Oh, this has that bit at the moment as well, where it's like they're sitting there and they're just waiting for it. It's just waiting for the fish. They're just like, yeah.
Now, I don't mean to make this about your color or your race, but you better hightail it out of here before you get hurt.
Boy. You know, it feels like it's about both those things when you end it with the word boy.
Here we go! Like, one of my only jokes in this thing.
The fact that you keep backing him to, like, Dolomite music.
To be upfront, the characterization of 15 here was inspired by the dub. The original Japanese version doesn't really do much of an adaptation with him at all.
Right.
He kind of just talks like this for the most part.
That's so strange.
And so when the dub came out, they got, I think it was Josh Martin, the guy who plays Boo. They decided to go with the, you know, 1970s blaxploitation inspired character.
That's what he looks like.
Which, again, not going to talk about whether or not that was appropriate. But
not our place.
Mm. But when we were coming up with the characterization, we're like, okay, we could go with something closer to that. And then Anthony was like, hey, I want to play that character. And I'm like, okay, all right, we'll go with that characterization. But since we were going with that, I was like, I have to get the right music for it. I have to get something that really kind of sells that.
Was that the same music you used at the beginning for the initial fight?
I used a bunch of different tracks.
Okay.
Some of it was stuff that was actually in the Megas XLR soundtrack. Some of it was
XLR.
Like, looked up, like,
this
hey.
Stuff sounds very Black Dynamite. Yeah, this sounds like.
We were talking about before we started recording this. There's only a couple jokes I know I had a hand in, and we're about to see it, and I'm very proud of the final joke.
Oh, yeah.
The final joke of one joke.
Super Saiyan, I'm not. You're still just a.
Bitch.
Yeah!
Did you just
throw a motherfucking dog?
There we go. He decapitates a lot of people.
Yep.
I'm loving the music for this, too. This bit is so good. Such a good shot.
Rip that joke.
Yep.
I love this shot. I just... love that. Ah, oh, so good.
So cool.
Countdown's just about over, you redneck.
Here's the...
Hey guys, I did that thing again where I sliced my opponent in two and they don't react until...
I did it first! You're not special!
But you don't even have a sword.
Okay, so those were the shots. In that shot, exactly.
Oh, yeah, you can tell.
Yeah, you can tell the eyes. Also, I like that Vegeta was trying to do a one-liner, failed at it, but then got saved by Trunks.
Yep.
And then gets angry at Trunks anyways. Good stuff.
14 and 15 have been destroyed?
Good.
Kieran was very insistent on that being the read.
Good. I feel like we should be stopping.
Look, it's Shitty Cell. It's kind of Shitty Cell, right?
By the way, I love Goku being like, nah, I want a good fight.
He's riding out!
Excellent.
Your back can never be too big!
Ultimate final pinnacle form.
He's Blanka.
Unstoppable. Blue! And completely taciturn.
I feel so bad about this, because once this happened, he's a great force, but now all the character's gone.
Yeah, well, that happens a lot.
Yeah, this guy is clearly meant to copy Blanka, right? Like, this is pretty obvious.
I mean, it's Blanka with Vegeta's haircut.
It's really Vegeta's hairstyle.
I mean, I don't know. Maybe it's Blanka. I
always thought it was Blue Blanka.
Blue Blanka?
Blanka.
Blanka.
Here comes... such a great joke from Vegeta.
Perfect.
Vegeta,
he stole your dew!
I'll kill him!
I'll kill him.
Oh, no.
No.
I'm still so proud of my read on that.
Oh, no.
The shudder in the voice.
Yeah, yeah, absolutely. Also,
the laughter.
Idiot.
Idiot.
Hold on.
Stupid, get my way!
Greetick, what are you doing?
We're trying to amp you up.
Well, it's distracting. Oh, shit, motherfucker!
Okay.
Remix.
Yes, that is a reference to Remix.
Time for me to kick some knee, motherfucker. Shit. Boom-chicka-ah,
boom-chicka-ah,
boom-chicka-ah, right. Boom-chicka-ah, green dick is better than blue dick, oh shit, motherfucker!
Alright!
Weekly was, tube show.
I remember when I sat down
first
to
talk, video I ever saw of his.
Yeah, I think that's the same for me too, and I remember sitting down.
What? I love that they were free references into like other YouTube like stuff. That's so bad, that's cool.
Before I had to leave, because I couldn't do the script, I was like, guys, is there any way to do the boom chicka? Like I we were talking about, and like Nick, you were for it. Scott was like, I'm always.
He was coming.
Scott was like,
nail,
it's
yeah.
not a shot against you. You're cautious because that's how you are. And he was like, well, ask Reem if he's okay with it. But how do we don't want to just do the joke again? I'm like, well, no. But he plays Kami, so we could cut him off because they don't get the full line out, and we could redo the. It's like the same joke, but is entirely interpreted a different way.
Yep.
But what's great about this is it starts with, he stole your dude. I'ma kill him.
I'ma kill him.
Joke. Grab. Joke. The screen, the effect, joke. I'll stop you, blast, joke. Laughter the whole time.
Get in my way.
Joke. This is one of the most joke-dense parts in any of our movies, as far as I'm concerned, because it's like within 30 seconds, there's at least 10 punchlines.
Yep.
It's insane, and I didn't write some of those jokes, but I'm just so proud how it all came together. Mm. Really, gotta reiterate that. So, let's do it. Take it away.
My turn.
Here it comes.
No, Sally.
Weakness identified.
The nut shot.
The cracked eggs!
Yep.
That's in the actual animation.
Animation. And now, something completely different.
Alright, Goten. It's your job to chuck these as hard as you can so I can be all trained up to face off against Dad in the tournament.
Oh my god, is that My Hero Academia?
Actor?
I fucking love Briner as Team Gohan.
Honestly, saddest thing about us not doing the Buu saga.
This was also around the time. I feel like
we had cast him as Cloud at this point.
Yes, we were working on Final Fantasy
right.
Mission Abridged initially.
Mission Abridged.
We had
cool.
cast him as Cloud. This is before he got cast as Deku in.
Oh, yeah, because I remember you guys like leaving comments when I was doing Mission Abridged that like it was the voice actor for Deku that did Cloud.
My Hero Academia.
Yeah, this is before My Hero.
Oh yeah, this was before My Hero.
Right,
before the boy got very busy.
This yep. was a few months before My Hero's casting, actually, if I'm remembering correctly. Actually, if I'm. Am I right on that?
I can't remember.
But this was it. But in the end, just hear him. It's so good.
Yeah, it's so perfect. Good. Honestly,
he fits so well.
Some people were really surprised. Like, that was your voice for Gohan? I'm like, yes.
Yeah,
and I
absolutely.
Love it.
It's just, there's a hero to it, you know?
Now stand behind that line and Goten? What was I doing here?
Wow. That's a great joke. That's absolutely a great joke.
I love that so much.
By the way, neat fact, the music in the background there is actually the Buu Saga, the Kai Buu stuff. I guess this was when the Buu Kai stuff was coming out.
Yeah.
That wasn't Japanese and American produced. That was only American produced, correct?
No, Japanese.
That was Japanese.
No,
too.
There's weird thing about it is that there's two versions of Buu Kai.
Mm-hmm.
There's the broadcast version, which is shorter and more cut down,
mm-hmm.
and then the international version, which is longer and less cut down and also more cheaply made.
Technically, there's a third version out there with a mysterious extra video with some familiar voices.
That's true.
Ooh.
Truly, they can't talk much.
Yeah, they voiced all the
much about that,
mind.
Though, can we?
Goku definitely said, wow, that was awesome. Goku totally said that, though. It's really true.
Anyway, I remember like all three of us cackling laughing when we came up with that.
That's
great. I was here for this one, right?
No, you were not there.
That was part
of the original draft.
It's so funny. He's not been there for these things. He's like, I wanted to be there, though. Like, I need some credit.
Raft,
I'm
hearing,
sorry, sweetie.
I thought this joke was written in a previous movie session because we were thinking about it during the dick kick scene.
Oh, actually, no. to be fair, we did come up with the concept. Yeah, we did come up with the concept of Goten disappearing before we actually.
Did we?
Yeah,
no, because we were talking about the dick kick, and Scott, I think, brought up the next movie. Goku gets punched in the dick, and we're like,
yeah,
"What?"
We did come up with the idea of like, what if just Goten evaded from existence?
Because I remember like it very differently. I remember us because we were writing it, you, myself, and Kieran in my apartment in my like you know. As we were just kind of like pacing around, talking it through, and I remember us laughing our asses off when we were like pitching that, when we were writing that scene out.
Well, I would say that maybe the concept was come up with us, but then it was brought back up again in the meeting, and then you guys wrote it out to this perfect extent.
So I mean, the writing for it was in during that session. I'm just saying the concept, I'm pretty sure it was floated before we ever sat down with Karen.
When we were talking about
again, memory is...
Hey, my memory sucks too. Yeah,
again, memory
who
is
are you guys talking
reconstructive,
to?
Not reproductive.
Who are you talking to? I misremember shit all the fucking time, which is right.
I know, I watch your clips.
I know, I watch yours too.
No, I mean, like, I see some of your clips like, somebody came up with that. It's like, I don't remember it that way.
Someone came up, I'm just like, I don't remember, because I always say, I only remember like 10% of the writing. The rest of it was just us banging our heads against the wall.
Yes.
God, so high-pitched.
Masako, amazing Masako.
Masako is always great.
He punched me in the dick. Why did he punch me in the dick?
That's not funny now, is it? Rot.
Is Goku gonna be okay?
Get the fuck off me!
Now I know
what you're
thinking.
I love that bit, and I will keep going back to the well for it.
Yep. So funny.
And the answer may surprise you.
Oh, man. Also, any excuse to make Masako go,
yeah, right.
Because he's just so good at that.
I do love, just like, Goku loves fighting. He even getting his ass kicked, he's like, I'm having a great time right now.
Oh, man.
By the way, this is the life.
By the way, him getting knocked out, I retimed it with the explosion to be more immediate. Yeah. Originally, it's explosion, and then you see him fly out.
Okay, cool.
Yeah.
That's a good edit.
It makes more sense for him to fly out with the concussive force.
Yeah, that's what I think, but,
hey,
you know.
Why didn't you pick on someone your own side?
There's no one wrong.
Clearly not me.
Well, if you can't
beat him.
This is creative.
Maybe one of those battle ball players? I mean, not that I watch sports. I have better things to do in my life.
No.
Wow.
Gohan's barely up to his knee.
By the way, I again, talking about characterizations for Gohan later on in the show that I wish I could have worked in earlier, the idea of him being the nerd is like, you know, I mean, sports are stupid. I don't care about them, but you might care about them.
I think that would have really...
That might be your thing.
I think what would be great about that is if we touched on it earlier on, Goku be like, but Battle Ball's so great. They all fight, and who's the strongest? I'm like, yeah, but...
do you know how many concussions they get? Because there's, like...
Come on, Gohan. I've had, like, 50 concussions, and I'm doing Obey.
Concussions? Sleep those off, Gohan, and then you're fine the next day. I don't know what is this?
You know how many concussions I've slept off? Dad.
Dad, you're not supposed to do that. Goku. Okay, Gohan, I'm going to be real with you here. I get hit in the head every day.
Gohan, listen to me. What were we talking about?
Yeah.
Did your mom get the crock pot? There's no character anymore. It bums me out. And
illuminate Son Goku. I love this run right here.
This is... Yeah, I love this run.
Good job, son!
Pleasant.
Let's try again, shall we?
Ow!
Nobody is killing that idiot but me.
Yeah.
Here we go.
Yes. Aw, you do care.
Fine, finish off.
Almost brutal shots in this show. Son Goku. The brutality is so nasty.
The squeak is great.
Yep.
And that's when the prince realized that when you grab a bull by the horns.
Mark Swint.
Yep.
Sometimes he'll take you for a ride.
Ooh!
Oh!
So goddamn brutal.
For that was like those old Dukes of Hazzard, like in between cuts.
Yeah.
Looks like them Duke boys are at it again.
There's like four separate interruptions during this
and
fight.
And the fourth one has a special guest star.
Some people kind of miss that because Swint has, like, they both have such a natural, deep southern accent.
Before you continue on, I want to point out that shot of Vegeta being bent over that fucking knee is probably one of the most painful shots.
Yeah, breaking his back like the
in
bat.
I can't think of a shot more brutal in this show. I'm like, there's some brutal ones with the guy being drank, but I'm like, is that the only one that even gets on it? Because it's just, he is like fully
He's fully bent.
It's
like, ah.
Keep it up, guys. You're doing great.
Help!
Yes, Lord.
love this speech.
God.
Hey, you big
with the Doctor Who theme.
Yep.
I'm a time traveler from 17 years in the future. And you don't
exist there.
You know why? Well, besides multiverse theory, yeah. It's because you die right here.
Right, die hard.
The look on his face.
Realized that his sword was about as useless as a screen door on a submarine.
Just whistling.
I love that subtle callback.
Yep.
Thunder!
That's when the green man realized. You suplex a robot. You better.
Oh, what the hell?
I love you can just hear him get up, crush the pages, and walk away.
Yep.
All right, Spirit Saiyan. What? Huh?
Kill Son Goku. Kill Son Goku. Kill Son Goku before it's too late.
Can I just point out that this is actually a really cool way of using the spirit bomb? Yeah, I actually absolutely. Really like this, as mm-hmm. in, like, he's got it charged, and he's just going to take all that energy into him.
I yeah, always thought that
that's
was the natural,
sick as hell.
That's a great yeah. idea.
I always thought that was a natural evolution of what this move was supposed to be, was, in the end, it's just all this condensed power from everyone.
And then you take it in, and then bam!
It, like, more like a focused power. Would be
I mean, neat. So many of the movies end with, like, guys, give me your energy, and I'll do something. Why not just like this?
Yeah, no, this was a cool... Really...
Imagine if this is how he beat Broly. Wouldn't that make more sense?
It's kind of how he did it.
Yeah, but not, except that it's, you know, just everybody handing him his energy. Just like, here you go.
Thanks, best buddy.
Here you go.
There's a cool shot coming up here, too.
Also, Masko screaming again.
Oh, yeah.
But let's go. Bastion. The Bastion OST.
Mwah. This bodes poorly. This fucking face.
Yeah.
Jesus
Christ! So intense.
That's the most Vegeta Goku ever looks.
Boom!
And that's when the robot...
DJ Sexadillionaire!
DJ Sexadillionaire.
...as a robot because robots are technically
off mic
by the traditional definition of...
These people even give a damn anymore? I swear they stopped
trying after season two. Which was, like, there are so many people where that was the consensus. It's like, oh, I can't believe they stopped trying. They sold out.
Why you guys stopped trying?
Why are you trying?
Which is amazing.
Why isn't it funny anymore?
Which is amazing because I don't think we tried harder than when we got to season three.
No, but we stopped trying.
Yeah. But why did we stop, though?
Yeah, why did we stop, though? Why did we stop trying?
Look,
after
we didn't
season
stop
two?
Trying until after season three.
Well, that's because we were. That's because you didn't like my pitch for BoJack. Stand by it. I also gotta. It's like because we. I feel like there in season two. There's more isolated. A lot of like really good rapid fire isolated episodes that were just fantastic in sequence. This was a lot of slow burn with big explosion comedy moments.
Geyser's recovering from my self burn.
Yeah.
Burn the whole house down with everyone inside. Block the doors so no one could leave.
Look, if you breathe the smoke in quick enough, it won't hurt as bad.
That's true. That's what weed smokers say. Scott.
Please continue to
play. Okie dokie.
It's actually a really sick.
It is.
It's
like finish.
There's a lot of fun ideas in these movies, you know? That's the
reality.
And
here's the great capper of it all.
Capper.
Yeah.
Capper.
I'd say pun not intended.
No cap. Oh, I love this animation. Oh, such a good effect.
Zach Manley killed it.
Hello. I love this Krillin line.
Man, catching Vegeta really
fucked my shit up.
How about you, Goku?
Because that's all he did. He caught Vegeta.
That's so good. Thank God.
Hey, that's great. So, you got any to share?
I kinda needed a few.
I'm glad you're all fine. But it does concern me that there are apparently more androids out there.
Actually, I had a thought about that.
Really clever.
Well, that was a total bust. I suppose I'll just continue nursing Plan B. That's another 17 years. I'm not going anywhere. Wait, what is that on?
Wow, Danger Will Robinson.
Oh, no.
I love that.
That's good. Oh, this.
By the way, this is sick.
Oh, yeah.
I can't believe... We
have the full version of it on
our channel. Oh, not just the song, but the song is really good. This whole thing, I asked Lawrence to put together a credit sequence. Oh, my God.
Mm-hmm. He really did.
You are, Taki. You're in the credits.
Yeah, I have. Oh, yeah, I played... That's why I always...
Selfie.
Just weird.
I always joke that you guys always are okay with me having, no matter what, one line of dialogue, so I can't really get to be on the IMDb line, because you'd hate that too, so I appreciate that.
There's only one.
That was class, though. It's just doing the one little noise.
One video of ours that I didn't have to record a line of dialogue
for. Which
one
was that?
The epilogue.
You're right! What the fuck?
Yeah, I guess that's true.
That's nuts.
We just reused a line that I
took a combo breaker! This is such a. I love this cover.
It's great. It's really cool. It's like, it fits in with the whole. Yeah. Ah.
Oh, yeah. No, it's stupendous.
Again, you can find it on our main channel. We do a lot of music.
We did a lot of music. We have albums.
Yeah, like, if you go. Yeah, all the Helsing Ultimate, like, Abridged songs are all there in full.
Full albums of music
by amazing artists.
And here's a joke from the dub that we decided to expand.
Oh, it's great. Yeah, I remember this. Yeah, the waiting for the fish.
Until the fish jumps.
So, what were you doing in the Arctic?
What were you doing in the Arctic?
I don't have a place to live!
What's your excuse? Look, Green Man, if you must know, I was just trying to find a place where I could be alone for a little bit and have some me time. Turns out, the Arctic wasn't the best solution.
Yeah, it would seem that way.
Hmm. Yeah.
It would.
So what do you do for fun?
Finn!
Oh, I get it.
Because there's a fish.
Fish.
I also played the fish.
Finn!
Bleeding Cowboys font. It is a despised font of people who know what it is.
It looks really try-hard.
That feels like one of the fonts in the back of one of those t-shirts. I am a man.
How does it even do that with the looping like thing around the end through the eye? Is that the eye that's doing that or the N?
You're preventing Scott from attacking me.
But
Keep talking.
That's part of I use that for the Helsing Ultimate logo.
That's a good fit for that, actually.
Oh.
Yeah, actually, it did fit very well for Helsing
Ultimate. I will always laugh, because this movie, you know, this might be one of my favorite movies we ever worked on.
I could see that on a pair of Levi jeans.
This movie makes me wish that... you ever have watch a project, you're like, I wish this was in the core canon in some way or another. Because I kind of wish when the androids showed up, they had like a giant battalion of different androids all over the place causing chaos. Like in one city, they'd have 13 and 14 doing something, another city 15 and 16 is doing it. And like, you just had this big plot where it's happening everywhere. I'm attacking everyone at once! More! Because I saw there were many Saiyans, so now I need more. Thanks, Trunks. Fuck!
I swear to God, though, these movies are bad.
They're not. I wouldn't say they're bad. They're not amazing. Like, I really want to buy the DVD box collection of the movies, because I do. But they've been added to Crunchyroll recently as well, haven't they? So that still puts me off from doing that. I could actually watch them if I wanted to right now.
There's so many fun designs in them.
I would not call them bad. I'd say, like, there are some Dragon Ball movies that are just outright bad. Most of them are mediocre.
Okay, so yeah, they're all right.
The cooler movies aren't good. Cooler as a character concept is
class.
Oh no!
I love
we had an actual pretty big debate when we were talking about our top villains with Kieran.
Yeah,
and
no, like
he's on the fence of like.
Oh, I think Cooler. I think Cooler's dumb as hell.
Look, it's my brother.
It's Riza's brother. It's in the horror. Hold on, it's fucking what's the chick from Little Mermaid?
Ursula.
It's Ursula's crazy sister! That's Cooler. The guy who's never talked about, who shows up, does exactly the same thing his brother does, and maybe has a cool form.
The point of what I'm trying to make is an additional onslaught of different androids of different looks is not a bad concept.
No, it's cool. It's like, it kind of, it fits in with the, like, whole thing. Like, it doesn't seem out of nowhere.
And some of them are really, each are distinctly different in design. Yes.
I mean, it could arguably give everybody their own fight, which is, you know, I mean, that's what One Piece did
that's what
Dragon Ball doesn't.
I will say this as well. Cooler, the idea of Frieza's having a big family was already instituted in the actual anime itself, where, yes, I'm his father.
I don't know about a big family.
He has a father. very big surprise.
Well, that's the thing. That's why I'm like, cooler as an idea of having an older brother is actually kind of a neat idea. Having him isolated to a non-canon movie, that kind of hurts the concept.
I mean, all the movies until Battle.
If you're on my side, chat. If you're on my side.
There's only one movie that could potentially even fit into canon, and that's BoJack.
Or the first movie.
No.
Dead Zone. Dead Zone, yeah.
Actually.
Nope.
The first movie can't fit?
Nope. Because
what?
Krillin knows Gohan exists by that point.
Yep.
That's true. That one. Damn it, Krillin.
Yeah. Nine is the only one that works. Nine is the only one
that takes place in that time gap.
Yep. Where
I guess technically Broly's Second Coming, but that would mean Broly would have to be canon.
People have stated that Cooler Broly could technically fit in between the time skip too.
Broly's canonicity is already completely out of like, because even if it was during that time between Perfect
the Cell games,
Goku and Gohan are not Super Saiyan, and that goes against the
law. Well, that's why we have them
in that 7-day period where they are Super Saiyan. That's why, because they aren't Super Saiyan.
That's
in the
why
movie.
We have that one. What about Cell? Fuck them. That's the end of that.
We'll wipe our hands away with that. We'll get to that at some
point.
This
was Super Android 13.
Yeah, Super Android 13.
That was great.
One of the most fun movies to work on. It was. It had so many like little bits in here. It was one of our goofier movies.
Yeah. Give Mick Lahr some love on Twitter, everybody.
Oh, Mick is amazing. Mm-hmm. Absolutely, give him some love. Mm-hmm. But with that, we're gonna move back into canon.
What?
Next time!
On this thing.
That we're recording?
You got it right last time.
With you.
You know, at this point, you've said that we're recording enough times.
Yeah, it's almost just... You're overplaying your hand.
I don't... But one of my hands is in my pocket. You're soft.
I know.
I find love.
Mm-hmm. That feels good.
You could have this. You were such a prick. Now take back what you said about me being bad takes. I'm angry!
Oh, that was great. That was really cool. I love watching these creator commentaries, getting behind the scenes, seeing the differences, seeing the edits, seeing the decisions they made, and who made the jokes, or who potentially didn't make the jokes. That was boss. That was really cool. And yeah, apparently we've got Boo Saga stuff coming up in Totally Not Mark's Boo Saga review, the Boo clip that they did at the end of the Cell Saga review was boss. It was really cool to see them back at it. So I think I've seen on Twitter they're calling it Boo Bits because they're not going to do it. But, you know, we're getting bits of what could potentially have been the Boo Saga and BoJack's happening within HFIL. So they are, you know, they're still things we wanted are still happening potentially. But yeah, that was cool. Thank you to my patrons. If you want to have your name at the end of every video I upload, link in the description to the Patreon page. $1 a month for Silent Special. That's greatly appreciated. Thank you guys very much for that. And thank you all for watching. What do you guys think of that? What do you guys think of this? Click like, subscribe if you haven't already. Leave comments down below. Let me know what I should watch and discuss in future videos. I'll see you guys. All you guys. Nick down.